Awesome. All right. Here we go. So yes, as you can see, here we have something that's actually not followed for a change. But now I picked up Transformers Devastation yesterday. And this is a game I've oddly been looking forward to for like a little while now. Because well, I'll be honest, I'm a bit of the nostalgic sort for the 80s sometimes. You know, never mind, I was born in like the latter half of it. But still, there were always reruns. And as cheesy as the cartoons were, I just couldn't help but love a lot of them, and Transformers for me was a big one. And then Platinum Games, I believe it is, made this one. They come out with this, which is basically like the old Transformers cartoon put in video game form. It's like, as far as I know, they have all the same, like most of the original voice actors, the art style looks pretty much exactly the same. They even got, and this is the real kicker for me, the guy that composed the music for the like the movie that they did based off of Generation 1 Transformers, you know, the one with Unicron. It's like, yeah, the guy who composed the music for that composed the music for this, and I've heard songs off of the soundtrack for this thing, and it's freaking amazing. So I'm actually honestly kind of excited. So let's get started, shall we? Yeah, no, I don't think I'm gonna go so high as Commander here. I don't want to get my ass kicked that badly. But pride dictates I can't take the easiest course either, so... Warrior seems... Let's go on straight and narrow on this one. It's going to ruin the morning commute. Well, they certainly didn't waste any time, did they?
Insecticons!
Plasma energy also detected.
It seems our theory may have been correct, Soundwave.
But plasma energy is unstable! No Cybertronian has been able to tame it since the Golden Age!
Then stand back, Starscream, and watch me tame it as I have tamed you.
Burn.
One of these days, Megatron.
Constructicons! Use the kinetic shields to build me a perimeter.
And where will you be, Lord Megatron?
We have been given a gift beneath the surface, and I intend to use it.
Nothing to see here, just a giant metal T-Rex.
Megatron and his Decepticons are already here.
Oh, the sound.
By the Matrix.
Ah, the classic sound
effect. On the plus side, I think we finally get to bust some Deceptor chops.
The humans are evacuated and our mission is clear. Save the city and stop Megatron.
Save most of the city.
Autobots, I am all right. We will rendezvous later. What in the world is all of this? Wheeljack, come in. Is this Cybertronian technology?
I think so, Optimus. They're creating hurricane force winds like they're trying to sweep the city clear.
Whatever their purpose, there is more to this situation than meets the eye.
When isn't there? He looks very imperious right now for some reason. Yep, you know, just taking in the sights. Okay, I'm assuming that's a good thing. I'll just play with this cab for a little bit. I can use it as a weapon. Perfect. Anybody call for a cab? Ground soldiers. Oh, I dropped the pet. Oh, that sounds good, sorry. I'm assuming there's a dodge button somewhere. How do I do that? Or will it tell me? Okay. It's been a long time since I've played a game like this. My timing is way, way off. Okay, alright, that's how you dodge. Alright. Now I understand. There we go. That's how you do it. Rank D. Not so great. Property description should help me out, I think. Aha! Smash, smash it.
Attack this Kion barrier repeatedly in a short time to destroy it. Then you may proceed.
Loop. the hell is that? Info logs. Insecticons. What are Insecticons? Insecticons are a different life form from Cybertron. They are Cybertronians categorically, but they are not the same as the Autobots and Decepticons. The Insecticons encountered here rely primarily on instinct and a hive mind to guide their actions. The last group of Insecticons that Optimus Prime encountered on Earth had distinct personalities, but these are different. These Insecticons were created and bred for one purpose, to serve their master. Whom they serve is a question that remains unanswered. Oh gee, I don't know, Megatron maybe? My money's on Megatron. So I see that thing there? Down here. Oh, it's down here, duh. Aha! Okay, now what is that? Air kit. Okay.
Hey, I found something. Follow me.
Well, it was everyone's favorite beetle. Transformer version of a butt stomp.
Stay focused. I think I can get through.
Plasma core is an ancient device, much like an Earth generator, that produced vast amounts of energy. Long ago on Cybertron, during the height of its peace and prosperity, its golden age, plasma cores were used with some regularity to light up entire sections of the planet. As Cybertron filled war and ruin, the technology to control plasma energy, thousands of times more powerful than regular energon, was lost. There is a plasma energy chamber deep within Cybertron's core that has remained dormant for millennia because of the danger of using it is simply too great. In order to cyberform an entire planet, a great deal of energy is needed to power the Insecticons and to make changes to the planet on a molecular level. To that end, no power supply short of a plasma core could be used to cyberform a planet. Crap.
I dodged too soon.
This is gonna take some time, isn't it? There we go. Oh. Okay. Oh, hello. B, that's better this time. Or not. Okay, I guess I just wasted that. Alright, fine, never mind then. Be that way. Expecting to run into him this soon. See ya. Legs. Oh crap.
If it grabs me, I am done for.
No kid. This is not going well. This is not going well at all. And I'm done.
Close call.
Oh, nice. Handy. No, you don't. Okay, he's down.
Devastator, you're needed elsewhere. The others can finish the Autobots.
Oh, what? I'm not important
Another
enough?
Time, Autobots.
Ready, ready, ready.
Oh, now I'm the wee little fella. I suppose that thing was only able to be activated by, say, a Bumblebee. No, that's the one I've already activated. And the other one was over here. Or... Okay, maybe not.
Bumblebee! Find cover and take out enemies with distance weapons.
Yeah, thanks for the advice. This can't. Cover. Yes, I'm going to go back and try that thing again. Maybe the machine gun. No. All right.
This is fascinating. I'll
Boom. Was that another one? Okay, that one worked. What the hell is it, bro? Or is that a different one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a different one. Oh, duh, it's right there. Well, hot then. Oh, look, another one. Okay, back to the airport, sir. Or was it another set of barricades? Oh, probably that one right there. How does cyberforming work? Cyberforming for idiots. Powered by a plasma core, carried out by millions of insecticons and terra claws that break down pre-existing structures, the Ferrotaxi supercomputer directs the process of converting any world into one capable of supporting Cybertronian life. The process known as cyberforming restructures a planet's surface as well as its core elements, converting high volumes of rocks and minerals into metals and energon, the life-giving building blocks of all Cybertronian life. What the hell is that? Come here, whatever you are. What the hell is a Krimzeek? Okay. Whatever it is, I caught one. Smashy. Now see, the Autobots say that they're here to save the city, and yet they keep smashing open the pavement looking for treasure. Teletran 1, always with useful information. Oh, I can fire the weapon. Fire the weapon while in car mode, too, eh? Nice. Ooh, mystery. I was gonna say mystery chest. Mystery object. Yeah.
Megatron, what is the meaning of this?
Optimus, come to save the day, I presume?
I am here to stop you from destroying the city.
Stop me? Oh, Prime, you have no idea what you're really up against, do you? Who is really behind this?
This is our home now, Megatron. We should respect it.
No matter, Prime. I have no interest in destroying Earth. But I'm not opposed to making a few, shall we say, improvements?
Bumblebee, you've got to break through Megatron's shield.
Smashy, smashy! Crap! Okay, you know what? I have to do this. I have to turn the music up a little bit. Okay, max power. Because again, the soundtrack of this game just kicks on my ass.
You must attack at maximum speed to break through a shield.
Like a maximum speed for maximum damage. Something like that.
What in Cybertron's name? Autobots, Megatron is headed for that steel tower. Move out.
Why is that capitalized? I don't think this capitalized can't be good. Steel tower.
I will cover you.
Follow me.
Go ahead. I will ensure no Decepticons follow.
Sure enough. I know this. Way we go!
If you use the wind current, you should be able to jump higher than usual.
Ah, space bridge. A space bridge is a device capable of bending the fabric of space and time to connect two points in space that are far apart with an energized tunnel or bridge. Once the bridge is traversed, the traveler can jump from one location to another. The traveler can jump from one location to another, be those locations kilometers apart or light years apart. His brain fried for a minute, that made no grammatical sense to me. Whee! All the goodness for Sideswipe. I believe that's what it says, Sideswipe. Kind of missed the subtitles there. Yeah, Sideswipe, that's what it is. So all these things I'm getting. Are they weapon enhancing? Oh, temporarily increases attack by 100%. So those other ones, though, are those just random upgrades to my weaponry? That I just get? I don't see anything about that in the menu, so I'll just have to assume that is the case and carry on. So Sideswipe kicks all kinds of ass, apparently. Devastating ultimate set. I'll be taking all of these. These are mine now. Oh, Optimus is getting curb stomped apparently. Teleprint. I'll take that under advisement. So is this some kind of Rick Echo thing, or is that just cyberforming? I'll say it's probably just cyberforming.
What is this stuff? Looks like Energon, smells like Energon. Teletran 1, analyze.
Analysis complete. It appears to be a volatile form of Energon. It would likely explode if you throw or shoot it.
Say no more. I think I've still got to sit so that all these little hints and crap keep popping up on the screen, too. I think I've gotten enough of a handle on the controls that I shouldn't need those, so... yeah, let's turn those off, shall we? Will it let me? No, I don't want to restore the defaults. It's not allowing me to turn those off right now. Maybe I won't get the option to do that till I get a bit further in. Ooh, shinies. Okay. Ferrotaxis is an important element of Cybertronians who long for a return to the Golden Age. It contains principles of the colony of Cybertron. Those principles were the foundation upon which the greatest era in Cybertronian history was built. Despite its cultural and historical significance, the Ferrotaxis is also a supercomputer that directs the Insecticons and the explosive energies from the plasma core to cyberform entire planets. The Insecticons are given instructions from the Ferrotaxis, telling them how to reshape the planet's surface, making it appropriate for Cybertronian life. Plasma Core's energy is used to alter the fundamental elements of the planet to create a self-sustaining environment capable of supporting Cybertronians. There is no Cybertronian that would wish any harm to come to the Ferrotaxis, despite its powerful abilities. When cyberforming a planet, it uses the colonnade as the basis for the society it builds. It literally turns a planet into a new Cybertron, physically, but also as a society. It must be protected if there is to be any hope of Cybertron returning to a golden age. But that's kind of what I'm trying to prevent here, because I guess they're trying to do that to Earth. Okay. Always with the seekers. Police. I got distracted because I thought they were having a little race or something. I was like, they're doing laps. Why are they doing laps? And can I join?
Yeah.
bring you down tomorrow. Right?
Dead ahead. Almost there.
It's Witwicky Auto Repairs and Tow Service. If you're at all familiar with Transformers, like even if you watch like the really shitty recent movies that came out, yeah, the name Witwicky should be pretty familiar to you. Why can't I... Well, I was gonna ask why can't I pick up the bus, but now I'm a bit more curious as to why it seems like the ground is made of ice. I mean, I realize I'm a huge frickin' robot, but should it be able to slide that easily? There's, I'm guessing there's absolutely no tread on those tires. It's like smooth. Can I push it into the windstream? Let's see what this does. Come on. Wow. So it pushes me, an alien robot, backwards, but even though I can push this bus around like nobody's business, the bus holds its ground against this supernatural wind. That's a burger? That looks more like a sub. What insanity is this? And now you will burn. Burn. Expecting something to attack me. Oh wait, correct me, something is attacking me. Jokes on you! I'm still alive! Kind of. This way. But what am I over here? Or I can just slam into the wall. Yes, indeed, I was over here. This way I can. No, this is the way I can. Okay, now I just got turned around. So I need to go that way? I guess I have to go that way. Okay, here are things I haven't destroyed yet. I'm curious. This brought me in. Pretty sure I've been here before. However, there's one of these weird things. Come back here, you weird, glowy bastard. Sure, this is where I was before. So I guess this is just some sort of shortcut or not. What is that precisely? Something I just can destroy. Because what is a game without its collectibles? Stuff for you to obsess over. Man, I don't even know what half this stuff I'm picking up is for. I mean, yeah, I know so much of it was for, like, regenerating health and weapon energy and stuff like that, but... Dude, everything else, I have no idea. Apparently I can go slamming into that building from this launch pad if I want to. That was poorly timed. Wait, does this thing make me go fast enough to smash through everything? Let's find out, shall we? Indeed it does. Sadly, I missed pretty much everything. going back the way I came. One criticism I did hear about this game is the camera can get a bit wonky sometimes. I can kind of see where they're coming from, especially when you're going as fast as this. I've ended up exactly where I left off, haven't I? Well. That's the old drawing board, as they say. Maybe I was supposed to go in down there after all. A hole in the ground. I can just look at the map. See, I need to go up there. So logic dictates how we go that way. Correct. The problem is that way leads to that wind tunnel, which I cannot get past. As I said, that hole in the ground I saw leads me somewhere. Like, you know, not the area. I thought I'd been to before. Now the $1 million question is, where the hell was the planet right here? Mystery solved. This time I'll pay a bit closer attention to the map, huh? No, that drags me all the way back here. Sir, I need to get up there. Try to get up there. Perhaps it's some fancy rooftop jumping which is required. No problem. Or, you know, if I had more of a runoff. Like so. Well, nothing else. I can take these assholes now.
For you.
Unless they just keep coming, which is possible. Yeah, screw it. They're not worth my time. Oh, duh. Build up a head of steam, and then drive my way up there. That's what I have to do. Bursting through their shields while I'm doing this. These collisions, and I'm not damaging Sideswipe's finish in any way, shape, or form. Whoever did the bodywork on him, man, they gotta be proud. Fucking Decepticons! I tell you what, you guys wanna stay there, you can stay there. Shit, shit. You assholes have to stop that. You have to stop that right now.
It's calling out to those Insecticons, somehow directing them.
Oh god, Megatron's tripping balls. He dropped some bad Energon.
My chariot awaits Optimus, but I cannot have you following me this time.
Dump truck ride, $3 for $1.
Sideswipe, don't let him escape.
Already on it.
Behind me now. Okay, he's got an attack form. Perfect. By perfect, I mean shit. Maybe, you know, turning around and stopping him, maybe.
Try it.
out.
Here. It will happen here.
Hi.
Megatron! What old block? It's about time. Let's talk, Autobot. More dying. Foolish Autobot.
That's the best comeback you got. What happens? Okay, I think it was those goddamn energy beams.
Destiny awaits below. As for you, I just engaged the security system. Good luck getting in, Prime.
I don't know, man. It seems like you're getting your ass handed to you by every Autobot on the planet. So.
Analyze.
It's a ship of unknown origins buried beneath the city.
How do I shut down the security system?
It appears there is a dual-layer security protocol in place. You'll first need to disable three self-generators. Once disabled, the primary generator will be vulnerable.
Autobots, transform and roll out!
Find the sub-generator. Secondary objective, try not to die, because holy crap, am I pretty close to it. Teletran Alpha is the original computer in the Teletran series. The first of its kind, it had a perfect operational record. There has never been a record of Teletran Alpha having made a mistake. Any mistakes made in which Teletran Alpha was involved have always been attributed to Cybertronian error. However, no Teletran since the Alpha has managed to maintain that level of integrity. Teletran Alpha may have been the crowning achievement of the Golden Age, and every subsequent Teletran has lacked pieces of lost technology that were part of the Alpha's core makeup. While the Teletran series continues to this day, making very few errors, they are somewhat diminished from the original. Ain't nothing like it was like it used to be.
Uplink activated.
And Grimlock. Makes sense. Burn Blaster. Thermal Hammer. Fire Sword. I'm assuming this is one of the... Oh, there's no restriction on who can use that. I figured it'd just be sideswipe. Sniper rifles cannot be equipped by Grimlock. Obviously, he's not solo enough for it. use grenade launcher. Twin blasters. Grimacria. How many of these things do I get? Twin thermal swords. Twin thermal swords again, like C. Machine gun. Lightning gloves. Magic hands. Okay, so is this going to stop anytime soon, or are they just going to give me all of the shitty weapons? I say shitty because they're all like rank D. Oh, okay. Okay, I can like purchase some shit. Characters. Oh, okay. I just got shunted into some kind of main menu here for some reason. Probably see if I can equip any of these things before I sell them, shouldn't I?
I think I see what we can make with these.
Sometimes I impress myself.
So basically, I have to pay off Wheeljack before he helps us? It doesn't exactly seem very sporting of him.
Fascinating! Let me see!
How the hell is this supposed to work?
This is legendary!
Oh. That works like that, apparently. Yeah, sure, I'll equip that. Hell, that was easy enough. Let's try it again.
I think I see what we can make with these. It'll work.
Okay, not as good, but I'll take it. One weapon will be upgraded while the other will be used for parts. Weapons used for parts will be expended. Basically standard procedure, I suppose. Weapon used for parts can also transfer skills. Multiple versions of twin thermal swords. What happens if I combine two different ones? Wait. 166, 58. Let's see. I really know better than that. What happens if I add this one? I don't feel like getting into all that right now, so let's just equip some stuff. Just basic stuff I've got. Yeah, this seems level of weapon I've got. Well, hell, you know what?
Megatron must be stopped.
What are we waiting for?
All right! Let's go!
Ready, ready, follow me!
Oh, I'm gonna play as these three guys, alright.
Megatron must be stopped.
Because I was gonna go for Grimlock, to be honest. Well, let's give the Optimus a crumple hammer. Sniper rifle too, see what that does. I'm hella proud of twin blasters. Give out those the other set of swords, things that, you know, I can apparently give them to him. Alright, let's just try that for now. I'm probably not gonna play for too much longer, but I don't know, let's give this another go, shall we? I'm assuming he said roll out then. In my mind, he said roll out. As wickedly slow as it's probably going to be. Oh, dudes.
Why don't the Insecticons attack us? Not that I'm complaining.
Strange. They don't seem to notice us. There's something different about these Insecticons.
Them though. Out of the way, I'm motors. Okay, you know what? Let's just say. Hammer seems neat and all, but just damn it.
Hey,
I'm a jerk. I'm not even gonna comment on that. Scrapper and Hook, eh?
Disengaging the first sub-generator now.
Yeah, it's bad that my first instinct was just to try to destroy the thing. No, we can be a bit more subtle about this.
First sub-generator shut down. The stronger currents should now be weakening. The next two sub-generators are now accessible. Shut them down in any sequence.
Great news!
That'll learn you. Too soon. Too soon, at least I'm losing myself. That's better.
You seem to be off point from your destination. Please reconfirm.
So the locked door is leading me in the wrong direction? No, it's not. Or maybe it was. those are from down here. Maybe I just need to go this way. Well, that's interesting. That's what the green thing is. Alright, it just didn't pop up on the map before. Oh, hey guys. Who do we have now? Skip. Oh crap.
I've been itching for a while. Come on.
And Bone Crusher.
Surrender, Decepticons. This is your only warning.
This isn't exactly known for being rude. Case in point. Okay. Crap. They double teamed me. Slides on him with the uppercut.
Shut down the sub generator.
I'm honest.
One sub generator remains. Once disabled, the primary generator is exposed.
Ouch. Yeah.
last burn.
How strong your steel, Autobots? How quick the conquest?
Well, that was rather poetic. And down again. Thankfully, I have a lot of these things. By a lot, I mean I have one more left. Okay, I don't have a lot of these things. Maybe I should be a bit more strategic about this. Yeah, it's all the dodging. I'm not doing all that well right now, apparently. Could have gotten a little bit better, could have gotten a little bit worse. I'll take it.
Shut down the sub-generator.
I haven't been missing any secrets like Decepticon flags or shit, have I? Probably. But...
Now, to shut down the primary generator.
Which is way, way back there somewhere, since... Oh, hi. sword. It is. I'm saying that bright. Decepticon, one bolt. Okay, maybe two for that one. And three for... Yeah. Forgot about setting that. Things. Of course, like any game of this type with items of this type, odds are I'm going to keep saving them, thinking, oh, I'll use them later, and oh, I'll use them later, and then by the end of the game, I have 50 million of them. You know, it's like if you're a Final Fantasy fan, elixirs. Elixirs are normally the thing there. It's like, oh yeah, yeah, I'll save those elixirs for when I really need them, and by the end of the game, you have an inventory full of them. I'm expecting something similar is going to happen here. Grab. I have no idea if he's even hitting me there. They don't seem to be hitting me though. Okay, that time they definitely did. Thank you. Drive away, drive away. Look at the itty bitty insect guns. Aren't they adorable? In heck, cute. There's a Ren and Stimpy reference for it. Alright, what's going on in here?
No one gets by the Constructicons!
Had to resort to this, didn't I?
All hail Megatron!
Nah. Also, where'd all the other guys go? They were here just a minute ago. Your leg. Okay, you don't need this. I mean, come on. You were doing just fine without him. I believe in you, Devastator. Magical flying Optimus. Not so magical, but entirely dead. Yeah, not entirely. I have one of the characters. Shit. Okay, this time I'm dead. Okay, so where's the retry gonna plot me? Okay, at a fairly decent spot. I get to try this again. First time around, is it? Nope. No, certainly not. Okay, one more try. And then I might have to leave this off for the night. Getting sleepy. Coordination is going. Urge to kill rising. Capacity to kill lessening. Calling the Autobot, I have a name. That's derogatory. Kind of. I think I feel like trying that again tonight. That's enough of getting used as a chew toy by Devastator. I think I might need to spend a bit more time maybe readjusting my kit, my equipment, and then come back and give it another go. So maybe Sideswipe would be a better choice. After leaving the arc, you will restart from your last checkpoint, so I'm probably going to have to go through that again. Work my way back up Devastator, but that's fine. Oh, and I get more things. That's nice. Shock Blaster. Serious Wound. A lot of them seem like they're pretty shitty, but... yeah, it's all the real basic stuff. Oh well. Now, I believe this game auto-saves, so if I leave... So wait, if I go to, if I go back to gameplay here, where's it gonna land me? You know, just for argument's sake, let's see where exactly it's going to start me off again next time. Right in front of Devastator again. Oh, nice. Well, at least I don't have to do any backtracking, but then I have to face this on first thing. Yeah, no, I think that might be enough of this for now. Well, this game auto-saved, so I'm assuming I should be able to pick up where I left off next time. Concept art and classic toy package art. Okay, some of this stuff looks pretty neat. Oh, I usually like it whenever a game allows you to collect or view concept art. It's usually pretty interesting to see, you know, how they got to this point. No, I mean, that's just Optimus. The dudes look the same since the 80s. Of course, we have ourselves some pretty badass pictures of Optimus too. Anyway, overall, thus far I'm enjoying the game. It is pretty much like ripped straight from the cartoon, so I appreciate that. The main issue I have right now, mostly, is just me. It's been a very long time since I've played a game of this particular type. I can't even remember the last one. Christ, I think I might have been God of War, and that was years ago. I don't even think it... No, I didn't even really play much of the third God of War game. I think it was the second. And holy crap, how long ago was that released? I don't know. Anyway, I gotta start getting back into the groove of these, what was it somebody called them once? Spectacle fighters? That's it, that's essentially what this thing is. But no, thus far I enjoyed it, and I'm definitely going to attempt to play this thing to completion. I mean, hell, I paid for it, it's just as well, right? So, anyway, I believe that's all for me for now, so, thank you very much, Lee, for tuning in as always, and I'll see you guys next time for a new exciting adventure with something. Will it be Fallout? Will it be Transformers? Maybe something completely different. Who knows? So, anyway, tune in next time, and you'll find out, and so shall I. Goodbye for now, everybody.